In the city of Baltimore, there has been a surge in violence. A record number of homicides have been reported over this holiday weekend, and city leaders are calling it disheartening. All of this comes just weeks after parts of the city were torched in the wake of the death of Freddie Gray and the police indictments that followed. Let me bring in CNN national correspondent Suzanne Malveaux. Suzanne.
Yeah, Brooke, it's just awful for the people in Baltimore. Baltimore City Police, they are now operating on high alert because of this deadly, murderous three-day holiday weekend for the city. Sergeant Jaron Jackson of the Baltimore PD tells CNN that since Friday, 28 people have been shot. Seven of those have died. Also, another alarming statistic, authorities are now saying at least 33 people have been killed in Baltimore this month. And according to Baltimore Sun's update, as of today, it might be as high as 35. This is the first time that this city has had 30 homicides in a month in almost 8 years. So the Mayor Stephanie Rawlings-Blake, as well as Deputy Police Commissioner Kevin Davis, they've come out. They're trying to address the residents to be calm. And people want to know what is going on. They talked to a local affiliate, WJZ.
It is disheartening that we're seeing such an increase in violence, especially when you think about the progress that we've made. We've come too far to have this type of setback.
Law enforcement, public safety, and the community will persevere over this small number of bad guys carrying guns, pulling triggers, killing people in our community.
So, Brooke, if you look at the list of shootings, where and who is being targeted, it is alarming. The shootings are taking place throughout the city. So we're talking about the western region, the northern region, and Baltimore Police Commissioner Anthony Batt says some of the shootings that's taking place in the eastern district is related to traditional gang violence.
I know that when you're looking at all these numbers, we're also learning that the arrest rates are going down while the number of shootings are going up. So could this at all be connected with, you know, the Freddie Gray death, the police custody, in police custody, the officers who were charged, any sort of hesitancy or, as we've heard, the chilling factor from police?
Sure, Brooke. Well, you know, that's something that a lot of people suspect. But actually, my colleague Miguel Marquez, he talked to a police officer who said, it is true that some police officers feel they no longer have the support of the police commissioner or the city's leadership. And so they're doing what he calls passive policing, the very least required
policing
to protect the community. That's right. He's only responding to 911 calls, not engaging the community any further. And here's what he told Miguel. I want you to watch this. Oh, I'm told we don't have the sound, but essentially, Brooke, what he tells Miguel is that they feel that they don't have the backing of their leadership, so they're not going to put their officers at risk. They're not going to put themselves at risk. They're going to have each other's back, and they are afraid that if they go out and do something, they might get in trouble if they are considered doing something too aggressive. And so they are responding to the 911 calls, but they are not going out and doing the traditional police community policing that they have been doing, what they say, in the past. This is very disconcerting to folks in the community. So what are they doing? Well, there was a group of residents over the weekend. They marched calling for peace. They went to City Hall. Also, Brooke, we expect tomorrow morning a pastor who is close to the Freddie Gray's family, Jamal Bryant, that he's going to be out there as well, because he says that the police department is no longer engaged with the community. And they've got a problem because they don't have the necessary funding for the Baltimore public schools. And summer's coming. The kids are going to be out. He says if we don't address this now, it's going to get a lot worse.
I know we've talked a lot to Reverend Jamal Bryant, but I'm so glad Miguel talked to an active police officer. We need to continue doing so in Baltimore. Suzanne Malveaux, thank you very much.